हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस ऑफ योर विच इज़ व्हाट प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री. एंड इन दैट क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू दैट. ओके, नाउ इन दैट क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज़ व्हाट स्क्वायर एंड स्क्वायर रूट्स. ओके डियर स्टूडेंट, स्क्वायर एंड स्क्वायर रूट. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्क्वायर एंड स्क्वायर रूट. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स सी. सपोज दैट स्क्वायर्स, यू नो दैट इफ वी हैव अ नंबर 5, ओके, एंड वी सेज दैट कि वी फाइंड द स्क्वायर ऑफ 5, देन इट मीन्स दैट वी राइट इन दिस वे. डियर स्टूडेंट, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्क्वायर इज वी जस्ट write the power of 2 of any number. Okay, so here this is 5 square. This is the concept of the square. Now after solving them, 5 5s are 25. So this is the square of 5. It means that the square of 5 is what? 25. This is the concept of square. Now what is the concept of square root, dear friends? Now let's see. If the square root of any number is denoted by in that way, a, the square root of a is denoted by in this under root. This is the this is your square root or under root. This is the symbol of square root. Okay, now let's see. So 25 is the square of 5 and the square root of 25 is 5. This is your square root. This is the relation between them. Okay, means 25 is the square of 5, but 5 is the square root of 5. Okay, so this is the concept of square and square root. Similarly, if we have a number 10, then the square of 10 is right in this way, 100. So 100 is the square of 10, but the square root of 100 is equal to 10. This is your square root. Okay, so this is the concept of square and square root. So please, dear friends, clear the concept of these topics. Okay, square and square roots. Now we are going to take and solve some important questions in your NCERT exercise based on the topic square and square roots. Let's see, dear students. And your concept is, let's see, your question is, what will be the unit digit? Your question is, what will be the unit digit of the square of the following numbers? Unit digit of the square of the following numbers. Okay, your question is, what will be the unit digits? What will be the unit digits? Okay, what will be the unit digit of the square of the following numbers? And numbers are what? First is what? 81. Second is one what? 272. Third one is what? 799. Fourth one is what? 3853. fifth one is what? 1, 2, 3, 4. And last we take sixth as what? 2, 6, 3, 8, 7. 2, 6, 3, 8, 7. Okay. Now let's see. What is the process to solve that type of questions? And dear students, here what we find? Here your question is, what will be the unit digit of the square of the following numbers? So in finding the unit digits of square of the any number, you just find the square of its unit digit. So the required number is the square. First of you find, in finding the unit digit of the square of the following number, you just squaring its unit digit. So after squaring the unit digit of the given numbers, so the unit place is the required solution of the given question. So let's see its solution one by one. So suppose that, let's see its solution. We have first part of this question is 81. So you source the, you thing is that, you think that key, first of all we square the 81 into 81. After that you find its unit digits. Because of, we find what? We find the unit digit of the square of the following numbers, na? So you don't find any square of the following numbers. You just find the square of its unit digits. So the square of its unit digits, after that you find a, what is the unit digit. So that require, that is your required solution. So let's see, suppose that we have 81. In 81, the unit digit is what? The unit digit is what? 1. Now you just find the square of that digit only, unit digit. So that is square of it, that is its square, means 1 square, that is 1. So the required unit digit of the square of 81 is what? 1. That is the unit digit of the square of 81 is what? 1. This is the required solution. Okay, so applying same method in all that type of questions. Now if we take the second part of this question, this is 272. We don't need for finding the square of 272. We just find the square of its unit digit. Okay, so here the unit digit is what? 2. So we just find the square of 2 to the 4. Thus the required solution is 4. Thus in this way the unit digit of the square of 272 is what? 4. You only find the square of its unit digit, and then after you get your result. Okay, similarly we take the third part of this question, which is 799. We don't find the square of 799, we just find out its unit digit. Here the unit digit of 799 is 9. We just find the square of 9. So square of 9 is what? 81. Now what we find? We find the unit digit. So the unit digit of the 81 is what? 1. Thus the unit digit of the square of 799 is what? 1. So 1 is the required solution. We don't take 81. We take only its unit digit after squaring the unit digit of the given numbers. After squaring the unit digit of the given number, you find the unit digit of the given numbers. Okay, so in this way you can solve each and every question of every part of that question. Now similarly, we take and solve the next part of this question, like fourth part. Fourth part is 3853. We find the unit digit of the square of the given number. We don't find the square of that number. We just find the square of its unit digit. So its unit digit is what? 3. So we find square of its unit digit, which is 3 3 is 9. So the required number is 9. Similarly, we take and solve the fifth part of this question, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. We don't find the square of 1, 2, 3, 4. We just find the square of 4 4 4 4 16. Thus the unit digit of that number is what? 6. So thus required number, required digit, required digit is 6. Okay, now, and we just find the sixth part of this question. Similarly, this is 2 6 3 8 7. We don't need to find the square of that number. You just find the square of its unit digit. Its unit digit is 7. So you just find 7 square. So 7 7s are 49. Thus the unit digit of that number is the solution of the given question. Okay. Thus in this way, dear student, you find the unit digit of the square of the following numbers. So using that concept, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay, dear students, now we take and solve some other type of question of your NCERT exercise. Let's see. We take some important question, and your question is, the squares of which of the following would be odd number? The squares of which of the following would be, the square of which of the following would be odd number. Okay, the square of which of the following would be odd number. The first part of this question is what? 4 7 31 2 8 2 6 7 7 7 9. Okay, now let's see its solution. What is the process to solve that type of question? Dear student, first of all, we know that dear student, this is a very important concept. The square of an odd number is odd, and we know that the square of an odd number is odd, and the square of an even number is even. So please learn the following concept. That concept. After that, you can find the answer of that type of questions. Your question is the square of which of the following would be odd numbers. What is the concept of odd and even, dear friend? That number which are divisible by 2, which is even, and which are not divisible by 2, that is odd. So, and we know that a very important concept, the square of an odd number is odd always. Suppose a 3 is an odd, the square of 3 is a 9. 7 is odd, the square of 7 is 7, 7 is a 49, which is also odd. So this is the concept of odd and even. Okay, ki the square of, so in this way here, 431, this is what? An odd number. So the square of 431 is always an odd number. Similarly, second part, 2826, this is even number, na, which is divisible by 2. So square of that number, not an odd number. Similarly, 7, third part is what? 7 7 7 9, this is an odd number because of its unit digit be 9. Okay, so this is an odd number, and the square of the following number, this number is always get an odd numbers. So in this way, you can solve that type of question. Okay, now we take and solve some other important question of your syllabus. Let's see.
Now, listen, we take and solve some other important question of your syllabus. Let's see.
Based on square and square roots. And your question is, dear friends, your question is find the square of the following numbers. Find the square of the following numbers. And your numbers are 35, second one is what, 86. Okay, now let's see its solution. We just find the square of following numbers. There is, in finding the square of following numbers, you just using the algebraic identities which you discussed in previous classes. You please, first of all, you learn the algebraic identities. You know that the value of a plus b whole square is what, a square plus b square plus 2ab, and the value of a minus b whole square is what, a square plus b square minus 2ab. So these are two very important algebraic identities related to your chapter. Okay, this is a very important algebraic identities. Okay, the here what we find, we find the square of the following numbers now. So we don't square that numbers, we just using that one, that identities, and solving the questions. Let's see what is the method to solve that type of questions. Let's see its solution. So first of all we take the first part of this question, which is 35. Dear friend, we find its square, 35 square. Okay, we find the square now. And square means what, I just discuss about that topic. Square means what, we just write its power 2. Okay, now what is the solution? Let's see. We can write 35 as what, in which form we can write 35 as 30 plus 5 whole square. We can write in this way now. Okay, now we solving that question by using that identity. Now here a is what, 30. This is your value of a, this is your b as what, 5. Now we expand that value using that identity. So we get what, let's see, we get as what, a square means 30 square plus b square means 5 square, a square plus b square plus 2ab, plus 2 into a means what, 30, b means what, 5. Okay, now we simplify them. So we finding its solution, 35 square is what, 30 square, 3 3 is a 9, 00, plus 5 5 is a 25, plus 5 2 is a 10, 10 into 30 means 300. Okay, this is, now we adding them, we get what, let's see, 9 3, this is 1200 plus 25, so we have 1225. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay dear student, so you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on the topic in this way. Now similarly, we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see. Second part of this question is what? 86. We find the 86 whole square. We find just square of the following numbers. Now, so we just find 86 square. Now, what is the value of its square? So we don't solving them by the product of 86 into 86. But we just simplify that question in this way. Let's see. 86 square. 86 whole square we write as what, 100 minus 4 whole square. 100 minus 4
whole square. Okay.
100 minus 4 whole square. Let's see. So, sorry, 90 minus 4 whole square. Nah? This is 86, not a 96. So, this is we write 90 minus 4 whole square.
Because of if we subtracting them, 90 minus 4, we get 86. Now, here we apply the identity what? A minus B whole square, which is what?
A square plus B square minus 2AB. So, we expanded them. Let's see. So, A square means 90 square, okay? Plus B square means 4 square plus, sorry, minus 2AB, na? Minus 2AB. So, minus 2 into A means 90, B means 4.
Okay, now what I do, dear friends, let's see. Now we just simplifying them.
So 86 square is equal to 9 9s are 81 00, okay, plus 4 4s are 16, minus 4 2s are 8 8 0 0 8 9s are 72. So in this way, now we adding and subtract 720, we get our result. Now if we adding, let's see, 8 1 0 0 and 1 6, so we get what? 6 1 1 8. This is 8 1 1 6 and minus 720. Now this is 720, subtracting them, we get 6. Yeah, 11 minus 2, which is what? 9 is left here. And here, which is what? 10. 0. This is 10. This is 3. And this is what? 7. Okay. 7396. So we get what? 7396. This is the required
solution of the given question. Okay, so using that concept, dear friends, you can solve so many questions based on these topics in this way. So please dear friend, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Now
dear friend, we take and solve some other important questions of your syllabus. Let's see. Now we discuss a very important relation formula related to your chapter, which is what? Pythagorean triplets. So property related to, we discuss about property related to Pythagorean triplets. This is very important topic related to your syllabus. Let's see. Dear friends, for any natural number m, the Pythagorean triplet are triplets are 2m, m square minus 1 and m square plus 1. This is one of the most important topic of your syllabus, and based on this topic there are some important question based on in your exercise. Let's see some important question. And your question is, find Pythagoras triplet. Find Pythagorean triplets whose one member is first, whose one is 6 and second
14. Second what? 14. Okay, dear students, now let's see.
Here, find the Pythagoras triplet, so whose one member is 6 and 14. Now, let's see its solution. So, whose one member is what? Now, first of all, we take whose one member is what? 6. First of all, 6. From question, suppose that we have one member as 2m is equal to
6. Okay, one member is 2m also. To 2m, we take 6.
Now, from there, we get the value of m is what? 6 upon 2, 2, 3 is a 6. So m is equal to 3. Thus, the other two members are m square minus 1, which is what? 3 square minus 1, 3 is 9 minus 1, that is 8, and next one m square plus 1, that is 3 square plus 1, so it is 9 plus, no, plus 1, this is 10.
In this way, the Pythagorean triplets are
thus required triplets are what? 6, 8 and 10. This is the required solution of the
given question. In this way, using that concept, to for any natural number m, there are 3 Pythagorean triplets are 2m, m square and m square minus 1 and m square plus 1. So using that concept, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT. Similarly, we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see.
Here, second one is what? 14 is there, no? Here, 14 is there. Let's see. 14. Now, here, one of its member is what? Here, one member take as 2m is equal to 14. That is, m is equal to 14 upon 2. That is 7. Thus, the other member... Other members are, first one is what? M square minus 1, that is what? 7 square, okay? 7 square minus 1, that is 7, 7 is 49 minus 1, that is 48, okay? And next one is what? M square plus 1, which is? What? 7 square plus 1. 7, 7 is 49 plus 1, that is 50.
Okay? So, in this way,
thus 3 Pythagorean triplets are, 3 Pythagorean triplets are, what? This is 14, 48 and 50. Okay. So this is the required solution of the given question.
Thus, in this video, student, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on Pythagorean triplet. Now, in next class, dear students, we take and solve some other important question of your NCERT exercise, and we also take and solve some important question based on Pythagorean triplet, and also we discuss about some important question based on square and square roots, okay, of your NCERT. First, you do more and more practices each and every question which we discuss in that class. Now in next class we take and solve some other important questions of your NCERT exercise. Okay dear students, now thanks to all.